What's going on, guys? It's the Bag of Tricks here. Welcome back to another video. Today is a video targeted towards new riders, very similar to my How to Hit a Rail on Skis video. Today we're going to be checking out how to hit a jump on skis. So while this is kind of targeted towards newer riders, it can still be used by more experienced park riders if they're getting ready to hit larger jumps, like 50, 60 foot jumps. Maybe you're stepping up from a 20 footer to a 30 footer. Maybe you're stepping up from a 10 footer to a 20 footer. It doesn't really matter where you are, where your skill level is. All these tips can still be applied to any size of jump. So you're probably sitting here thinking, well, hitting a jump is pretty easy on skis. You just kind of go straight at it with enough speed and you hit it and you land and you ride away, right? Well, there's a lot more that goes into hitting a jump than you might think, especially when you start getting into more poppy jumps or just larger jumps in general. There's a lot you have to think about. So the first major thing and probably the most important thing about hitting a jump is how fast do you have to go to hit this jump to land in the sweet spot or to at least clear the knuckle. There's two things that can happen when you get the speed wrong. Either one, you come up short and land on the knuckle and case the jump, which is gonna hurt very bad for your heels, knees, ankles. You can end up kneeing yourself in the face. Just, you don't wanna do that at all. And number two, you can end up overshooting, which generally, you don't get hurt as bad depending on how deep you send it, but it's a very scary experience. So either way, we wanna get the speed right. So how do we figure out the speed of a jump that we've never hit? The best way to do this is to find somebody who has hit the jump, ask them what the speed is, maybe even follow them into the jump. This is what I do every time I go to hit a brand new jump. When I went to Mount St. Louis and I was hitting jumps that were bigger than I've ever hit before in my life, I got the down low from the locals. They told me exactly how fast to go and I trusted them and I sent it and it was perfect speed. But without knowing that, I probably would have came up short on my first run and that would have not been fun at all. So getting somebody that knows the speed of the jump already is very important. If you can't do that, if there's no way that anybody around you has hit this jump yet, at least give it a speed check. So what I mean by that is come into it as fast as you think you need to go, and right when you get to the lip of the jump, just slide up it sideways and stop and kind of get a feel for, you know, was that enough speed? Do I think I need to go faster? At that point, you're just going to have to guinea pig it and hope for the best, but literally the best way and the safest way to hit a new jump is to get somebody that has already hit it. So next up, what you want to think about is your balance heading into the jump. This is very, very, very important. And you know, if you get this wrong, it could end up in you going super backseat, maybe even going all the way to your back. And that's just something we really want to avoid. That's why I'm trying to make this video. Because the main thing that's going to go wrong is, one, you either get the speed wrong, or two, the lip of the jump, you let it fling you backwards way too much, and you just completely lose your balance and end up landing on your back or backseat. So to avoid this, you want to do what I'm doing above. In this picture, you can see I have my knees bent, my shins are in the front of my boots, my weight is forward, I'm loading up and getting ready to go, I'm ready for the lip, and I'm not going to let the lip throw me backwards. If you were to come into a jump with your weight on your heels, maybe your knees aren't as bent as mine are here, you could be surprised by the lip. You know, I think that's what happens with a lot of riders. They'll hit a lip that they haven't hit yet and they'll be surprised by how steep it is or how fast it comes up on them, and they'll let it throw them backwards, throw their body weight backwards. And that results in, again, landing backseat, landing on your back. I've seen guys land on their necks from that, just getting thrown off by the lip. They're not prepared for it at all. But if you're in this position, you're going to be prepared for it. It's not going to surprise you. Your weight's going to stay forward. And then when you get to the top of the lip, the end of the lip, you can then pop. This is a very solid, stable position. It's a position that you're going to take a lot of times going into any trick. But especially for jumps, it's important to you know, stay low, stay forward, and not let that lip chuck you backwards. All right, so you got the speed right. You got your balance right heading into the jump. And now it's time to take flight, my dudes. So what do we do next? What do we do to make sure that we're staying super balanced in the air? The very first thing you want to make sure you're doing every time you hit a jump is getting a solid pop off the lip. Without getting a solid pop off the lip, you could let the jump really determine your balance in the air, and that's something that feels really terrible. People that have hit jumps a lot like me probably know what I'm talking about. When you don't get that solid pop, or maybe your balance is a little off heading into the jump and you come off of it and you just feel out of control, you're maybe a little backseat, and you're gonna flail, 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 and it feels terrible. So If you really want to control your balance in the air, you have to set it right on the lip. You have to make sure that you're not letting the jump determine what happens to you balance-wise when you take off of it. So keeping your weight forward, you're going to pop off the jump just like you would pop off the ground if you're trying to dunk a basketball. Just pop hard, but keep that weight forward. You do not want to pop and lean back unless you're throwing a backy. That's obviously very understandable, but if you're just trying to straight air jump, do not pop and lean back. Pop, keep your weight forward. At this point, your legs are going to be slightly extended, and then what we want to do, and this is how you're going to get extremely solid balance in the air, and you're not going to be flailing all around. It's just going to feel much more smooth, much more natural, is once you pop, your legs are going to be extended at that point. So then you want to suck them back up, bring your knees up towards your chest a little bit, get back in that position you were in when you were coming into the jump, but do it in the air. And then that is a solid, again, a very balanced position, and it's going to feel very natural. If you can get this down, then you can obviously work in grabs, work in shifties, but you always want to get that pop and then bring your knees back up and get solid, get compact, and get into a position that you're going to be comfortable with flying through the air. So once that's all said and done, your balance in the air, you got the speed right, you had great balance coming into the jump. The next thing to do is to just land and ride away. When you're just straight airing jumps, this is pretty simple, man. You just spot that landing the whole way, plant your feet, ride away. If you're landing in the sweet spot, it's gonna feel smooth, it shouldn't hurt too bad, and you should be a baller on the jumps now. It's just that simple. One last thing for people that are trying to send like 60 footers like I did this past winter for the first time, I just want to give you a little heads up. It's really, really easy. The jumps are so large that you're never really going to get thrown backwards too bad, because you're actually traveling up the kicker portion of the jump for so long that you can't really get caught off guard by how kicky or how poppy it is. So don't really worry about that. Big jumps are super easy. You just got to get the speed right, man. Thank you guys for watching. I wanted to go in depth on this so I could help the new rider really break down a jump and how to do it the right way, the safest way. If you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, make sure to subscribe, and I will see you again in a future video. Peace.